स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू विद्या मिराज। दिस वीडियो इज मेड फॉर क्लास 7 ऑन चैप्टर नंबर 4 सिंपल इक्वेशंस एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन विद एक्सरसाइज 4.3 फ्रॉम एनसीईआरटी। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, सॉल्व द फॉलोइंग इक्वेशंस। नाउ वी हैव कपल ऑफ इक्वेशंस गिवन टू अस, वी विल सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशंस डायरेक्टली बेस्ड ऑन द थिंग्स व्हाट वी हैव लर्नड इन द प्रीवियस एक्सरसाइज। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट पार्ट। 2y plus 5 upon 2 is equal to 37 upon 2. So the first step, plus 5 upon 2 will be taken to the other side, will become minus 5 upon 2. So what my suggestion is, you also do along with this so that you become more confident. So while seeing it, you do it. So 2y is equal to 37 upon 2 minus 5 upon 2. So we will solve the right hand side by taking the LCM. It will become 32 upon 2. So 2y is equal to 32 upon 2. Now we have to make variable y alone. So 2 will be taken to the other side in the denominator. So y is equal to 32 upon 2 into 2. So it will get cancelled. Y will come out as 8. We can even check our answer in this type of situations. We can put the value of 8 in place of y and check whether our left hand side answer is coming same as right hand side or not. 5t plus 28 is equal to 10. So 5t is equal to 10 minus 28, which is minus 18. So 5 will go on the other side, it will become t is equal to minus 18 upon 5. A upon 5 plus 3 is equal to 2. So what is the first step? A upon 5 will be equal to 2 minus 3, which is minus 1. So A upon 5 is equal to minus 1. Now to make A alone, I have to shift 5 to the other side in the numerator, and it will be multiplied. So A is equal to minus 1 into 5. A comes out to be minus 5. You can check your answer by putting the value of A in the respective equation, and you will see that left hand side will be equal to your right hand side. Q upon 4 plus 7 is equal to 5. So first step, Q upon 4 will be equal to 5 minus 7. On solving, we get minus 2. So Q will be equal to minus 2 multiplied by 4, which is equal to minus 8. 5x upon 2 is equal to minus 10. So first step is we will take 2 to the other side. So 5x will be equal to minus 10 into 2. Now I have to make x alone, so 5 will go down. So x is equal to minus 10 into 2 upon 5. We can cancel it, so x comes out to be minus 4. 5x upon 2 is equal to 25 upon 4. So what we will do is, the one which is in the numerator will go in the denominator, the one which is in the denominator will go into the numerator. So x will be equal to 25 upon 4 multiplied by 2 upon 5. So 2 was there in the denominator on my left hand side. When I take it to my right hand side, 2 will go up. 5 is in the numerator on my left hand side. When I shift this side to the right, 5 will go down as denominator. So it becomes 2 upon 5. It can be reduced, it can be cancelled. So x comes out to be 5 upon 2. 7m plus 19 upon 2 is equal to 13. So first step, 7m will be equal to 13 minus 19 upon 2. First we will solve right hand side now. Take 2 as an LCM. It will become 26 minus 19, which is 7 upon 2. So what is m now? M will be equal to 7 upon 2 multiplied by 7. 7, 7 gets cancelled. We get 1 upon 2. We can even check this by putting the value of 1 upon 2 in m, and we will see that our left hand side will be equal to our right hand side. 6z plus 10 is equal to minus 2. So 6z will be equal to minus 2 minus 10. So what is minus minus? We will add, but the sign will be of minus. So minus 2 minus 10 will become minus 12. So 6z is equal to minus 12. Z will be equal to minus 12 upon 6, which is equal to minus 2. Next part. 3l upon 2 is equal to 2 upon 3. So we will make variable l on my left hand side and shift others on my right hand side by changing their position. So 2 upon 3 will remain as 2 upon 3, multiply sign, and again it is 2 upon 3. So l becomes 4 upon 9. 2b upon 3 minus 5 is equal to 3. So first step, minus 5 will go to the other side. So 2b upon 3 is equal to 3 plus 5, which is equal to 8. So now what is 2b? 2b will be equal to 8 multiplied by 3. 3 was in the denominator on the left hand side. I have to remove that. To remove that, I will take it on the other side, right hand side, and multiply. And I have to remove now 2 from b. 2 will go down in the denominator. So b is equal to 8 into 3 upon 2. It can get cancelled. So b's value is 12. I can check this answer by putting it into the value of b. I will see that my left hand side is equal to my right hand side. Solve the following equations. 2 into x plus 4 is equal to 12. Now here my first step is to open the bracket. 2 will be first multiplied by x, then 2 will be multiplied by 4. So my new equation is 2x plus 8 is equal to 12. Now again the same rule will apply as we have done in the previous questions. So 2x will be equal to 12 minus 8, which is 4, and 2 will be removed from x. X will be equal to 4 upon 2, which is equal to 2. I can even check my answer by putting the value of x as 2 in that brackets. 2 into 2 plus 4, 2 plus 4 is 6, 6 into 2 is 12. So my left hand side is equal to my right hand side. Next, 3 into n minus 5 is equal to 21. Please remember that when there is a bracket, the number outside will be multiplied for the whole. So that is why 3 will be first multiplied by n, then 3 will be multiplied by 5. So 3 into n is 3n, 3 into 5 is 15. So 3n minus 15 is equal to 21. So minus 15 will be removed and taken to the right hand side. So it becomes 3n is equal to 21 plus 15, 3n is equal to 36, n will become 36 upon 3, which is equal to 12. Next, 3 into n minus 5 is equal to minus 21. We will quickly do it. Now we know how to do it. So 3 into n, 3n minus 3 into 5 is 15, which is equal to minus 21. So 3n will be equal to minus 21 plus 15, that is minus 6. So n will be equal to minus 6 upon 3, which is equal to minus 2. Minus 4 into 2 plus x is equal to 8. So minus 8 minus 4x is equal to 8. Now remember, we have to remove minus 8. Okay. So minus 8 when go to the other hand side, it will become plus 8. What is left on my left hand side? Minus 4x. Please take care of this sign. So minus 4x will be equal to 16. What is x now? X will be equal to, please shift minus also to the other side. It will become minus 16 upon 4. So x comes out to be minus 4. Now 4 into 2 minus x is equal to 8, which is 8 minus 4x is equal to 8. So you have to remove 8 from the left hand side. When you take it to the right hand side, it will become minus 8. What is left on the left hand side? Minus 4x is equal to 8 minus 8. 8 minus 8 is 0. So what is x? X will also come to as 0. Question 3. Solve the following equations. 4 is equal to 5 into p minus 2. So we will try to do it in two ways. I will teach you. The first way is open the bracket. So when you open the bracket, so 4 is equal to, it becomes 5p minus 10. you will take to the 10 to the left hand side. So 4 plus 10 is equal to 5p. What does it mean? It will become 14 upon 5 is equal to p. Now other way around, choice, there is another method. What I can do is, since 4 is equal to 5 whole into p minus 2, I can take that 5 on the other hand side and take it to the denominator. It will become 4 upon 5 is equal to p minus 2. So I can take 5 only in the case when it is divided by whole bracket. Okay, if it is 5p minus 2, then I cannot take and divide 5. So remember that this can be applied only at particular situations. Now what will I do? I need to take 2 on my other side. Minus 2 will become plus 2. So 4 upon 5 plus 2 is equal to p. Here now you have to take the LCM. It will be 5 LCM. So 4 plus 10, which is 14 upon 5 is equal to p. So these are the two ways of doing the particular question. Both way you see that answer of p is coming as same, which is 14 upon 5. Now as per my suggestion, best way is to do what is we have done it earlier. So practice the way you find it comfortable. Let us do the next one. Minus 4 is equal to 5 into p minus 2. So here I have opened the bracket. So minus 4 is equal to 5p minus 10. So 10 we will remove and take to the other side. So minus 4 plus 10 is equal to 5p, which is 6 is equal to 5p. So p comes out to be 6 upon 5. 16 is equal to 4 plus 3 into t plus 2. So what is the first step? We have to remove 4 and take it to the other side. So 16 minus 4 is equal to 3 into t plus 2. Open the bracket. So 12 is equal to 3t plus 6. Remove 6. So 12 minus 6 is equal to 3t. 6 upon 3 comes out to be t, which is equal to 2. Plus 5 into p minus 1 is equal to 34. So first step, 4 which is on the left hand side can be shifted to the right hand side. So it becomes 5 into p minus 1 is equal to 34 minus 4, which is 30. Open the bracket, 5p minus 5 is equal to 30. Now we have to take minus 5 to the other side. It will become 5p is equal to 30 plus 5. So 5p is 35. What is p then? 35 upon 5, which is equal to 7. Next part. 0 is equal to 16 plus 4 into m minus 6. So take 16 to the other side. It will become 0 minus 16, which is minus 16 only. Open the brackets now. It will become 4m minus 24. Now remove 24. It will become minus 16 plus 24 on the left side, which is equal to 4m on my right hand side. Minus 16 plus 24 is 8. 8 is equal to 4m. So 4 will go down. 8 upon 4 is equal to t, which is 2, the value of t. Construct three equations starting with x is equal to 2. So when x is equal to 2 I have, what I am going to do, I can either multiply both the sides by 3. So it becomes 3x is equal to 6. So if I have to find out the value of x, so x is equal to 6 upon 3, which comes out to be 2. So that is how we are going to formulate the equations. Next we have to make 3 equations. So first equation is 3x is equal to 6. Now I can add 2 on both the sides, so it becomes 3x plus 2 is equal to 6 plus 2. That is my second equation, 3x plus 2 is equal to 8. For the third equation, I can divide both the sides by 3. So 3x upon 3 plus 2 upon 3 is equal to 8 upon 3. So x plus 2 upon 3 is equal to 8 upon 3. That becomes my third equation. See, this is just an idea how to create the equation. You can choose your own way of doing it. The thing is, the value of x should come out to be 2. For the next step, we need x is equal to minus 2. So here again, I have multiplied both the sides by 3. So 3x is equal to minus 6, first equation. Second equation I have added 2 on both the sides, so it comes out to be 3x plus 2 is equal to minus 4. Third equation I have divided it by 3 on both the sides, so x plus 2 upon 3 is equal to minus 4 upon 3. So this is how we have done 3 equations when x is equal to minus 2. That's all for this exercise, children. I hope you must have found it simple, but you require practice for this. Please do all the questions again, step by step, slowly and slowly, because this is the base of your particular chapter. It is very, very important for your future classes also. So you should be strong in this, how you will find out the value of the variable. If still you have doubt in any of the parts, you can mention in the comment section or you can also email me. Thank you so much, children, for watching the video till the end. Very soon I am going to come with the next. Till then, see you, children. Goodbye. Take care.